Anyway, enough of us did to carry on for those who couldn't. The engineers who had been working through the night were still at it during the day, trying to get dry crossings laid down. You couldn't tell them that the Ruhr wasn't much of a river, as rivers go. It was raining where we were, but it wasn't only raindrops we had to duck getting across those bridges. Hurt. There wasn't much left on the far side, but enough for the enemy to dig in and make things unpleasant. The fella had to keep his eyes open every minute. Even so, a crouch behind a pile of rubbish could let him have it. We took Julich, and there could have been a big time in the town if there'd been any town left. Matter of fact, there wasn't much time. The heavy stuff was getting across the Ruhr, catching up with us and going on ahead. Advance units were spreading out on the plains before Cologne. Country was just made for tanks. I guess for walking too, because we were there. Yeah, I love a parade. Flags flying, bands playing, and crowds cheering. We weren't wasting sympathy anymore. After Malmedy, being hard-boiled made good sense. Those old men, women, and kids, and all those meek, mild prisoners heading back to the cages were a poison to us. He wasn't ready to give up Cologne. It was too important a town. So we brought up some new arguments to help change his mind. Somebody was going to have an awful headache. After their own neighbors being killed. After the guns, it was up to us again. Thank you. Cologne now, and we were on the Rhine. Big news broke at Remagen. Call it a lucky break if you want, but the way I figure, everything that happens is a break. Only it takes somebody on his toes to turn it into a lucky one. First Yanks had gone across the Rhine, but it had cost plenty to stay there. Old-timers who'd seen action in Italy said it was like Anzio. The medics had a job on their hands, but it had always been a job from D-Day on. It took guts to go out where things were popping the way they did. The Red Cross might be a protective marker, and again, it might be a nice, clean target, easy to spot. The Remagen beachhead held and grew. When the old bridge went down, there were other crossings to take its place. When we finished, the only thing German on the other side was some Valentines left behind by the local comic. After Cologne, Koblenz was next on our list of cities. We were teaching the Kraut that anything he tried to defend was going to be smashed. He should have learned fast because it was a lesson out of his own book. We were reaching the river at a lot of points in that sector, and that meant the German line between the river and Saarbrücken was breaking wide open. Before we could take advantage of it, though, there would be plenty of cleaning up to do. There were towns that had been bypassed. And pockets of enemy to be mopped up. The job was finished and we waited for the next round. There was time out for a little fun. Horseplay, I suppose you'd call it. Hitler Youth just couldn't savvy. Adolf had never mentioned rodeos. We had fun in our decadent democratic way. The new move was shaping up, and everybody knew it was to be another of those combined operations. Most everybody had a good hunch, too, where it was going to be pulled. It was going to be the swell show put up at Nijmegen, and it was going to be that knockout punch we'd all been sweating out.